לנו נשמת to Shimshon Chaim ben Nachman Michael Nachmani and לנו נשמת to David ben Imar Shalom
Shmuel ben
Malka Shlomo ben Yafa Mordechai Demikre Jora ben Ona Bibi וגם תמר בת רחמל מיריאם בת פרחו מלוא רפאל בן פרחו וגם מלוא יעקב דמיקרא ישע בן שרה וגם לפואה שנאמר כל חולם ישראל בכללם דור בת יון טוב אברהם דמיקרא אברש בן שרה
משיח
בן בלור יוסף שלום חי
בן
חנו עובדיה בן לאה רפואה שלמה פרחו בת מלכה מרים בת מלכה זויה בת שורו ככה Rosa Bad Balor. Soro Bad Miriam. Ksiyo Bad Adina. Dora Bad Soro. Rafa Shlema. Yosef Ben Lea.
Yosef Ben
Brach. Rav Aryeh Lev Shteinman Ben Sara.
Uriel Ben
Malka. Zohar Bad Soro. חיה בת חנה בת טובה רפואה שלמה לכל חולי עמו ישראל וכן יהי רצון ונאמר
אמן
אוקיי ויהי בשלח פרעה את העם and it was when פרעה sent the Jewish nation out is that true? פרעה sent them? Not Hashem sent them? Is it פרעה can do something? Hashem runs the world. Who takes Jewish people out of slavery? Paro lets them go? Fine. Kosher. Yesterday I heard good word. I didn't hear it well. But someone said, saying Yitziat Mitzrayim is not right phrase. What means Yitziat Mitzrayim? Coming out Egypt. Should be Yitziat Mi Mitzrayim. I'm coming out from Mitzrayim. What means coming out Egypt? Remember the question. After we have, I have my own chiddush on this. You'll like it. We say Egyptian coming out. You know, we don't say. We should be saying coming out from Egyptian. From Egypt. You don't say Egypt coming out. Yitzhak Mitzrayim means Egypt coming out. Does it make sense? Not right. You say coming out from Egypt. Now, let's go word by word. Later by later, and we'll get some beautiful stuff today by Zad Hashem. Vayhi b'shalach paro et ha'am. And it was when Paro sent the nation out. Koshe! It's a question. It's difficult. Lama lo amar vayhi kasher hotzi Elohim mi Mitzrayim. Why does it say, and it was when Hashem took the nation out of Mitzrayim. Why it says Paro took them out? That's first question. Second question. Kmo shamar ha'katuv, it says, what it says later on, El Motzei mi Mitzrayim, Hashem took them out from Mitzrayim. I don't understand, if Hashem took them out, why are you giving credit to Paro here? That's first question. Second question, Omao ki karov hu, what Hashem did? When Jewish nation came out from Mitzrayim, Hashem didn't let them go to the land of Plishtim, but Hashem turned away and they went to the desert. One second.
They did not go to war.
Why they didn't go to Plishtim? Because it's close. So what is close? The Plishtim are close, so what? Could be they'll go back to Mitzrayim. When they're going to be war with Plishtim, the nation will go back to Mitzrayim. But again, why do I need to know this? Because it's close. What does that mean? Because it's close. Would be far, wouldn't be problem? Because it's close. What if it's far? They're not going to go back. They will go back. A place where you used to, it's still better than a place where you're not used to. Since they used to be in Mitzrayim slaves, they'd rather be slaves there than there. So they will walk even far. So why are you saying, my Torah says, because it's close to, they went around different way, further way, and to the desert. Why there's two reasons. Kikarohu, because it's close. Ki amar Elohim, because Hashem said. Two reasons. Because it's close, and because Hashem said. And also many, many more details that this parsha talks about. Two things are bothering us today. Number one, why it says Paro took them out. Number two, Hashem made them go around. That they shouldn't go to Plishtim, and they went around to the desert. How do you say the word around? In Hebrew, to say around is means misaviv. But Hebrew, the Torah says vayasev. Vayasev Elohim. What's vayasev? The same word of like this. Haseva.
To recline.
Of reclining. Haseva. Hashem said, I will make you go around. So by reclining, you should remember, I made you go around. I didn't go make you go plishtim. This is not what Zera Shimshon says today. I learned this many years ago. First time I heard from Rav Moshe Volki, my Rebbe. But let's get what Zera Shimshon is saying today. It's beautiful stuff. If you will get to the bottom of today's parsha, your Pesach Seder will be much easier, much simpler. Pesach Seder will be much easier. And we're starting. The answer is, Ve'esh Lomar. Lefi she'Yisrael tza'aku el Hashem. She'yotzeihem mi'Mitzrayim. Jewish nation, they screamed to Hashem. And they said, please Hashem, take us out from Mitzrayim. Kedichtiv, as it says, Ve'ye'anchu b'nei Yisrael min ha'avodah, Ve'yiz'aku. And the Jewish nation rested from the work, and they start screaming to Hashem. Hashem, take us out from here. Take us out to freedom. Ve'ikar ze'aka hi zohi lefi sha'ayu sovrim she'nishlam haketz bekoshi ha'shibut. You know, when you are in the middle of the problem, you never scream. You scream when the problem is almost over. When you feel the problem is almost over, then you start screaming. For example, a king has a key of freedom from the jail. He's a mile away. Will you scream to him? No. When he's two steps away, you will scream to him. Same thing. We're in the Jewish nation. We're in Mitzrayim. They were slaves. They couldn't scream at the beginning. But when they suffered the 210 years, the suffering of how long they were already, of course they were working from 86 years to 116, 119 years, not more than 119 years. There's different opinions there. But when they felt, because we suffered so much, it's over, they start screaming, Hashem, take us out now. We feel it's over. Why they felt like this? Because the suffering was a lot. You know, sometimes when you have hard days in your life, you feel, what's going on with me? What is happening to me? No. The suffering days that you have, it shortens the suffering. When you little by little come up, it's going to be long. Dolgei grashi, they say in Russian. Long term. But when something harsh coming up, it's going to be short period of time. Day two, bam. Bye bye. Next. It's gone. V'yikar ze'akai zo'i lefi she'ayu sovrim she'nishlam ha'ketz bekoshi ha'shibut. They thought, this scream is because they thought so much suffering, it's already almost over. Ve'tzaku el Hashem, and they screamed to Hashem, she'yagbir midat chasdo aleihem, so Hashem should put his character of mercy over Jewish nation and take them out of slavery. U'kshe'shama tzaakatam, when Hashem heard their scream, kedichtiv, as it says, hine tzaakat bnei Yisrael ba'a elai, Hashem says, oh Moshe, take them out because their scream reached me. The scream reached me. There's two types of crying in the funeral. There's crying for personal purposes that doesn't go anywhere, and there's crying that reaches the heaven, which is said towards that Sha'arei dim'a lo ninalo. The gates of the tears are never closed. Which tears? Priest Krau used to say, if the gates of the tears are never closed, why do I need gates there for? If the gates are always open, why do I need gates? Oh, to know which guy is real, which guy is fake. Which guy is fake. Huh? I can tell. We are, sadly to say, friends with people's faces. What's in person's heart, Hashem's friend. So how can you tell? You cannot tell. You see people sitting in front of the dead person, screaming. You ask him a question, why are you crying? If he says, I'm crying because I feel bad for him, we're on the right track. He says, what's going to happen to me when I'll pass away? We're in the wrong place then. He cares about himself, doesn't care about the dead person. A person doesn't care about the dead person, cares only about himself. What is it worth?
What if it's for his family? He's crying for his children, not for him that he's dead, but he's crying for his wife, she's now alone.
So what's he doing here? Go home and cry at home. Why are you crying in public here for? It's a big point. Do you know the whole mitzvah to go to the funeral is to save person from the Gehinnom?
It's what?
Is to save person from Gehinnom. And a person who speaks Divrei Torah, he should be speaking only about that person. Some people talk about third relatives, that has nothing to do with this. It's a big problem. The whole meaning of funeral is talk about him. En omrim bifnei amet ela devarav shel met, says in the beginning of our brachot. Look at page 3. Okay. Hine tzakat bnei Yisrael ba elai, nira sheiskim lesvaratam, comes out that Hashem, seems that Hashem agrees to them, says, listen, you want to come out? I'll take you out. Ve'im nishlam haketz. Okay, fine. Hashem needs to take them out. Im nishlam haketz. One question now. Jewish nation came out, yes. Is the time came or no? Not yet. We don't know it yet. If the time came, why do I need to know? Paro should let them go. If the time didn't come, makes sense. Paro didn't want to let them go because time didn't come. So, the time of 430 years that Hashem said to Abraham, is the time came or no? If the time came that they should be free now, I don't need Paro's permission to go. I could go simply. The door is open. Since the time came to be free, they already freed people. Really? Hashem desired to take them out. But every person, every nation, especially Jewish nation, has good angel talks about him in Shamayim and bad angel talks about him in Shamayim. When something good time happens to you in the world, right away bad angel talks about you, against you, to cause you trouble. Right away. This is why it says in the Gemara, Ashrei Adam Mefached Tamid. A lucky is a person who is always scared. He's always scared. Even though I'm having good time right now. In a wedding. Person's a wedding. Don't lose yourself out of your happiness. You know how many Ashkenazi people died during their children's weddings? Bukharis, we don't know this, Baruch Hashem. Ashkenazi, many, many people. Rabbis and non-rabbis. A lot of them out of happiness, they got overboard. They got very happy and they... it says have always like
control,
because sometimes don't get too, so it says Ashrei Adam Mefachet Tamid. I'm not saying he's not mefachedi pastor chasham. No, no, I just gave a wrong example. It's my fault. But a lackey is a person who is always scared. You have a good time. Don't be so happy about it. Relax. Relax. Cool off a little bit. No, there could be something bumpy here. Same thing here. Even though Hashem said, I'm going to take them out, right away, bad angels singing in Shamayim. Ah, the time didn't come yet. Why are you taking them out? Ah, it's not the time yet. Right away, Malach dancing around. אין לשם מפני קטרוג מידת הדין שהייתה טוענת שעדיין לא נשלם הקץ. רצה הקדוש ברוך הוא שפרעו יעשם בני חורין. השם said, bad angel, you singing? השם said, I am taking them out. He is taking them out. פרעו is taking them out. This why it says what? ויהי בשלח פרעו. And it was when פרעו let them go. Do you understand the point here? To close the mouth of the bad angel, Hashem made it seem as if Paro letting the nation out and not him. Vayomer lahem, hare atem bnei chorin. Vayan beparasha kodemet, as was explained in the previous parsha. Umeata, and now, im hayomer hakatuv, so if the Torah would say, and Hashem took the nation of Israel out of Mitzrayim, guys, if you don't understand something, it's okay. Tell me, show me your finger like this. I'll go over, I'll go three times over. Umeata, and now, im haya omer hakatuv, if Torah would say, vayihi kehotzi Hashem et Israel, and it was when Hashem took the Jewish nation out. Hashem took them out and not Paro. Haya mashma sheotziem bizmanam. I would think, what? When Hashem takes them out? On the proper time. You know, never in the world. Never. You know, sometimes couples fight, husband and wife, and they say, maybe we're not for each other. Maybe you should have married somebody else. I should have married somebody else, right? They get like bottom line. Oh, you know, we have to go to a rabbi or somebody, magician, I don't know. People go today to anyone you want. Let's find out if we're for each other or not. And now Torah says, if you and your wife entered under the chuppah life, it means you for each other. Good luck.
You're at your own risk.
You don't like something? Work it out.
No
replacements. Work it out. You went under the chuppah life, yeah? Nothing happened to anybody? No. That's for you. And what? You cannot rush your time. It says, whoever rushes time, time rushes him. You can't rush your time. So everything is a proper time. If Hashem would take them out from Mitzrayim, means what? If Torah would say, Hashem took the Jewish nation out of Mitzrayim, what would be? A proper time came here. So since it doesn't say Hashem, how the parasha says, Vayihi beshalach Paro, and Paro let them out. So means what? It's not proper time. It's not, would be Hashem, if Hashem's name would be in the parasha, that Hashem took them out, means proper time. But here is not proper time. Kmo she'em tzaku elav. Haya mashmash yotzeem bizmanam. Kmo she'em tzaku elav. So it's not proper time. Why are they screaming right now? Yes?
Comes out that we came out, it's like probation, but we're not free yet. You know, when they send you out of jail, you're on parole. Probation. Parole, is it? Parole?
Yeah, parole.
No, parole when they...
I don't know which college you finished, which classes you took,
jail, you
which classes house. You took, but I'll tell you one thing. You have never in your life speaking so perfect on the proper spot the way it was right now. Because it was probation, Hashem couldn't take them to the police team. Now we'll see how deep it goes. You put on the proper knopka, you know? I liked it. Let's go. Just look at this. If I would say, Hashem took them out, means they come out on the proper time. As they're screaming at him, Hashem, please take us out, this proper time already. Hashem knows it's not proper time. But still Hashem takes them out. How? Not to himself, through Paro. Now let's see. If so, Avi milchut delech plishtim. If so, even though they would go through the way of Plishtim, lo haya ole al da'atan lachzor le-Mitzrayim, they still wouldn't go back to Mitzrayim if Hashem would take them out. But when Paro, Hashem forced Paro to make them into free people, to make his servants into a free nation. Shizmana mucha she'adayin lo nishlam haketz legamre. Shemizeh muchach. Muchach she'adayin lo nishlam haketz legamre. From here we see the proof that the time of slavery didn't finish at all. Utzichim hem lalechet begiliyot acherot. And they have to go through other sufferings to fix it fully. Me'ata efshar she'im yolichem derech eles plishtim she'ilzu lachzor. They would say what? You know what? If we go through Plishtim, that's new immigration for us. We'd rather be finishing our slaves there, slavery job in Mitzrayim, than finishing Plishtim where there's immigration for us, new place, we don't know the place. Hashem said, I cannot take them to the Plishtim. If I take them to the Plishtim, they'll get stuck there. They'll get stuck there. They're going to be a war, and they'll come back to Mitzrayim. I don't want to take them to there. Why? Because the whole situation is a raw. The food is not fully cooked. It's a raw case. The slavery is not over. They're still slaves. How do we know all this? You sit on Pesach night. You drink 4 cups of wine. Why? Do you know what wine represents on Pesach night? Blood. You see, we drank it in Mitzrayim. We drank it during the Spain Inquisition. We drank it during Holocaust. And unfortunately, we're still drinking it. Every year they're bombing us and throwing bombs on us. And they want to destroy us. So Jewish nation, this shiur is very deep. It's not so simple. It looks simple. But it's so deep. You could sit on Pesach night and say, guys, do you know why we're still sitting here? We're happy. But yet we're celebrating something deep. What? That 430 years of slavery in Mitzrayim began then. Still didn't finish. We'd be finished. We wouldn't be sitting here like this now. Look at the words. Me'ata efshar she'im yalechem den echeles plishtim she'elzu lachzor. U'mishum hachi. Amar hakatuv davka. This why, since the case is raw, it says what? Vayhi beshalach paro, and it was when paro let them go. V'lo nacham. Hashem didn't let them go through Plishtim. Sha'arei. Mishlichut ze mashma ki karohu. From this, sending, it seems, kikarohu, because it's close. Because it's close. Kizman geulatam, nikrav kodem zmano. What means kikarohu? Because it's close. What's close? Not only close the place, they're close to the redemption. They were close to the redemption, but it was not fully cooked. To go to the redemption. It was close time. It was not original time. Umitam ze. And because of this reason. Ki amar Elohim. Peni nachem ha'am. This is what Hashem said. Maybe the nation will be relaxed. Calm down. And then they will see the war. They'll go back to Mitzrayim. Pirush Rashi, what Rashi says, Yachshuvu machashava al sheyetzu veitnu lev lashuv. They will come to think, to come out from this land, Plishtim, and go back to Mitzrayim where they began the slavery. Yachshuvu machashava al sheyetzu kodem tashlum minyan ketz. Hashem said they will know that they need to fully cook the food to get it fully ready to to finish the slavery, so they'll decide to go back to Mitzrayim and finish the slavery fully there. Next. V'zehu she'amar ha-katuv, and this is what the Torah says. I'm sorry for those who are tired. I really understand you went through hard day. Not so simple. And here we gather late at night. But I know one thing. For every second we sit here and learn, Hashem will give many, many times the reward and will make many, many, many miracles. Whoever has hard desires, Hashem should fulfill all the hard desires.
Amen.
And this is what the pasuk says in the Torah. V'lo shamu el Moshe. When slaves were serving, they were working with a hammer or anything, they were building bricks. Moshe comes and says, guys, I have good news for you. Hashem took you, Hashem sent me to take you out, soon we'll be all out. Tell me, they were happy or they were sad?
Sad.
They were, they couldn't breathe normally because of short breath. They couldn't listen to Moshe Rabbeinu. And he said, you know what? Get out of here. I don't understand. You're suffering. Somebody wants to take you from suffering. You will tell him, get out of here? You will throw rocks on him? You have to tell him, thank you, be happy. Look why they were not happy. There's something deeper than this. Look what it says. V'zir shamar ha-katub lo shamu el Moshe. And they didn't listen to Moshe. Ve'ad rabba, opposite. Hayah laim le'idnachem b'shomam b'sura tova. They should be listening to this good news. It's a good news. Ki shmua tova tedashem etzem. Listen to the rule. Rule is, it's a big rule. You hear somebody die, don't spread to people. I'm telling it to myself. Why? When you tell people bad news, their bone shrinks. Gemara says. You cause them shrinking of the bone. But when you tell somebody good news, this is what it says here. It says, in Mishle it goes, Kishemu atova tachem etzem. When you give somebody good news, his bones become fattened. Ah, they feel good. Person's bone becomes like stretched, not fattened. Ella, Yisrael ayu mitiyarim. I don't understand. If Moshe Rabbeinu wants to take them to freedom, why they're scared? Why they're upset? Why they're not happy? Because they were scared. What's from what? Pen yitchayvu lalechet tachat malchut achelet leishtabet. One second here. They were here 210 years. How many years they should be all together?
430.
220 more to go. Moshe Rabbeinu says, I'll take you out. They said, what? No. We don't want to go. Why? Because once we're not slaves here, we have to be slaves somewhere else to fulfill 430 years, to make it full. We don't want to start new immigration from slavery to slavery. That's not a bracha. We don't want to go through this.
So they knew how much time they had left?
100%. It's openly. Look how it says openly here. They knew exactly that to that. They knew Hashem spoke to Avram. They knew Hashem said, I'm going to take you out. After 130 years, Penny Tribu Laleche Tahat Malchud Achel Shabbat, Vainu Mikotze Ruach Meawada Kasha Ha'atida. What's the short breath and hard work? They'll tell you, people say, in Mitzrayim, they were hard. Not true. Not Mitzrayim. They were short breath, hard work of the future slaveries. They said, we don't want to go to different slaveries. That stretching us out. We don't want to hear him, Moshe Rabbeinu. Get out of here. Sha'arei, kodem ze ketiv. Ketive. Why do we drink 4 cups of wine? Because of 4 languages of the redemption Hashem said. What is that? Ve'otzeti, and I took you out. Ve'itzalti, and I saved you. Ve'ga'alti, and I redeemed you. Ve'lakachti, and I took you for myself as a nation, right? Tell me the truth. This I will learn every year. Zera Shimshon opens new gate here today. He says, honestly, that's not true. Only Pesach night happened to us, Ve'otzeti, Tochka. Nothing else yet. Other stuff will be in future from different slaveries. This is what it means here. This is why we drink 4 cups. Why? Because we know slavery is not over yet. We're still going through other ones. And I'm sure Inquisition, Spanish Inquisition was one of them. Holocaust was one of them. And could be the 4th cup is also over. We're waiting for the 5th one soon. Vehem romzim. These 4 languages, Vo'otzeti, Ve'itzalti, Ve'ga'alti, Ve'lakachti, are hints for different slaveries. Legaluyot acherot, from different redemptions, from different slaveries. Uchtiv, And it says, "Vaydaber Moshe ken," and Moshe said so el bnei Yisrael to bnei Yisrael. She'amar lahem, Moshe said to them, "Ken mamash sheramaz lahem agaluyot." It's true, the way Hashem give you hints of this galuyot. You're right. In the future, we'll be slaves again. Ela she'im yitkaimu bnei Yisrael shelo yechatu lo yelchu od begalut. But you know what? Every day, Hashem judges the world. Gemara Kiddushin. If you do mitzvah, first, put it tefillin, let's say. Your day will be going to the mitzvah side. If you start from sin, your day will be going from the sin side. Same thing. We came out from nation from Mitzrayim, Hashem said, 210 years passed, 220 years on the air. You will pass through, not to do golden calf. I'm taking the 220 years and burning in with ashes. Nobody has to suffer. If you will do sin of a golden calf, then you have kippah on your head for 220 years. Three sleeves. Kalpok, they say in Bukhari. Let's go further. I'm 5 minutes done. Uchtim, v'edaber Moshe ken al bnei Yisrael, she'amar lahem ken, mamash, she'ramaz lahem agaluyot, ela, she'im yitkaimu bnei Yisrael, she'lo echatu, lo ilchot begalut, k'mo she'pilashnu le'el b'parashat shemot, al daya le'tzara b'sharte. When person is suffering, and you come to him and say, ah, oh, don't worry, you're going to take three pills, you're going to be okay, but in 2 months you're going to get sick again. He said, excuse me, I'm not suffering enough that you remind me what's going to happen in 2 months? It's enough for me to have pain now. I don't want to hear nothing else. This is what happened to Jewish people in Egypt. Moshe says, guys, I'll take you out. Don't worry. But you know what? In future, we'll have some more slavery. Isn't this enough of suffering now? Huh? This is what Hashem said. I have to command. Hashem said to Moshe, tell command to Jewish nation and to Paro. To take out Jewish nation from Mitzrayim. Why do you have to tell Jewish nation? Why do you have to command Jewish nation to come out? They didn't want to come out. They said, we don't want to come out from slavery to go to different slavery. From the fear of different slavery, they didn't want to come out. Remember I asked you a question today? Why it says coming out Mitzrayim? Should be coming out from Mitzrayim. Yitzhak Mitzrayim means coming out Mitzrayim. Should be coming out, it's at Mimitzlam, right? The answer is, honestly to tell you, some people, they were in, during Lenin's time, or Stalin's time, they worked. They walked, face like Stalin, with the furashka, everything. Stalin died, already finished, fully. Religion came to Russia. Still that person was walking like this. That's a problem. You took Stalin away, but you didn't take Stalin out of this guy. We came out from Mitzrayim, but till today, sometimes Mitzrayim follows us. So we need two Mashiachs. Why do we need two Mashiachs? We need one Mashiach is good enough, no? Mashiach Ben David comes, case closed. Why do we need two Mashiachs? One Mashiach to take us out of this world. To take us out of Mitzrayim. But we need second Mashiach to take Mitzrayim out of us. That's what we need. This one says Yitzhak Mitzrayim. It doesn't say Yitzhak Jewish nation from Mitzrayim. Because there's still some Mitzrayim is already inside the blood. So I have to take that Mitzrayim out of you. This is what Paro says. Mazod asinu. Paro said, Moshe, you're taking the... Look, Paro was not fooled, guys. Paro knew everything about 430 years. Paro says, Moshe, what did you accomplish? You coming out, you take them out, fine. But they're going to be slaves again. Mazot asinu. So what did you do? Kishilach ne Israel me'ovdenu. That you took the nation of Israel out of the slavery. What did you accomplish here? Bevadai she Israel yu avadim pa'am acheret le'ezo uma. Again, Jewish nation will be slaves to the other nations. Kedei tashlum arba me'od u'shloshim shana. In order to fulfill 430 years. Mazot asinu. Kishilach ne Israel me'ovdenu. So what did you do? Okay, fine. The Jewish nation is not servants to me. They're going to be servants for different nations. So what did you do to them? What did you accomplish? Bishlema, it's good. Im yihyu bnei chorin. It's good if they'll be fully free. Lo hayti omer klum. Paro says, I wouldn't say a word to you. But they come from slavery to slavery. So what did... Nothing, no benefit. V'chen amar lahem, re'u ki la'a neged penechem. Paro said, Moshe, you're taking the nation out? Look there is a bad thing in front of you. Do you know what Paro saw? Let me tell you what Paro saw here. This midrash begs for explanation. Number one, Paro saw there's a star from heaven coming down and is falling in the desert. And the name of that star is Ra'a, means evil. So Moshe Rabbeinu said, we're taking the nation to the desert and serve Hashem there. He says, don't do that. It's still my slaves. I'm responsible for them. You take my people to the desert, there's a star falling. Moshe Rabbeinu, after he gave him Makot, he says, listen, you're beating me up, fine. You're taking the nation, but you're still putting the nation in danger. Because there's a Ra'a in front of you. What Ra'a? One of the opinions means that star. Second opinion is, really? There's different opinion. What? Golden calf. Third opinion we see today. Paro said, you're taking them out of this slavery, but still there's different slaveries. There's still different slaveries. What is that? He meant on Holocaust. He meant on Inquisitions. He meant on different things that destroy Jewish nation. Today we were learning, finishing Siman Yud Zayin in Eben Ezer Shulchan Aruch, and I learned something new today. Aruch HaShulchan, he brings in one of the last laws of Yud Zayin, chapter 17, and he says, if a woman during the plague says, my husband had black, do you hear of black disease?
Black disease?
Black plague.
Black plague. You heard of this?
Yeah.
How many people died that time?
A lot.
It's how many years ago?
Black.
700 years ago.
Yeah.
It's called black plague. You know how many people died?
It was in Europe.
From seven... It was in Europe, exactly.
It was from the rest.
Third.
Almost 200 million people died.
How many?
Almost 200 million.
Thank you. From 75 million to 200 million people died. You know what happened? It was from rats. They blamed on Jews. And you know how many Jewish people they killed because of this? You couldn't fix it. And people had the black spots in their hands. If you see the video over there, not video, the pictures. It's scary how they suffered. But the bottom line, they blamed on Jews. They killed Jews for this. Paro saw this already. Paro saw this. Somebody will be killed. They blame on Jewish people that will use the blood for Pesach. And they'll kill Jewish people for this. Like this, many, many times Jewish people suffered. Why? Paro saw they... Ooh! See in the future, there's a bad star in front of you. Okay. Shehine Abraham birera malchiyot b'makom geinam. Ve'in lo yashlimu zman agalut, im ken chayavim geinam. You know what it says here? It says, Abraham Avinu loves you. He prayed for you that you should go to different kingdoms to be slaves in order not to suffer in Gehinnom over there. What is that teaching you? He says something beautiful. Look what it says. This is a book talk. You could talk about this one book, but you know, I like to talk short. So look what it says. Ve'im lo yashlimu zman agalut, im ken chayavin Gehinnom. If in this world person complains and suffering, says, Hashem, I have this problem, take it away from me, I don't want a problem, Hashem, sorry, I'll take it away, but you have to pay for this over there. So sometimes person suffers here, should say, you know what, everything's from Shamayim. But over there in Shamayim, he's going to be good. I'll tell you, today, what day today? Today is February 7. I'm telling you now, yesterday somebody in Yeshua took a video, but Baruch Hashem, he did some cutting some pieces openly in front of one rabbi, respected rabbi from Israel. One Bukharan man decided to get up in public and embarrass me for no reason. I was thinking, should I answer? I put my head down and I was sitting quiet. Rabbi Shaul told me, I don't know you. I see you first time in my life. He says, I give you kol hakavod for self-control. And I said to myself that, Hashem, maybe I made some averot. Please, take my averot because of this. I'm ready to go through this. How many? 200 people sitting. 100, at least 140 people were sitting there. At least, at minimum 140. Gan Eden. Big room, packed. Suddenly somebody, boom! Worse than that. And you know what I told you? It's not him.
You passed the test.
It's not him. It's him.
Yeah.
If I don't go through this, I have to go through this somewhere else. This is life lesson to you. One guy, his wife was washing him out in the house. You like this, you chisibekor, you this, you that. He goes and says, Rabbi, I don't like her, I'm going to get rid of her. Rabbi said, you know what? If not at home, then in public. You have to get it. Somewhere you have to get it. You're not going to get it here, you're going to get it, but you have to get it. So therefore, anything happens. Baruch Hashem.
Rabbi, Bill, let's play lottery. Something good supposed to happen to you.
Why, you want to take me with you to be a partner?
I buy the ticket.
Ah, then 100% goes. Let's go. 2 minutes. ואתם רוצים לצאת קודם זמנכם? רוקי, תפלו בגיהנום. He says, you want to come out before your time? Look, you're going to end up in גיהנום. 1 minute and we finish. Bottom line. וכשראו ישראל שמצרים רוצים אחריהם, when Jewish nation saw the Egyptians were running after them, מחמד הטענה שעדיין לא נשלם הקץ, because they say, hey, where are you going? Your time is not, how do you say your time? Your time is not due.
Up.
Your time is not up. You have to stay long and come here. I'll give you a shpalow. Amru, halo ze adavar, asher dibanu elecha b'mitzrayim lemor. Is this the thing that in Mitzrayim we spoke? Ve'echan diblu ze b'mitzrayim. I don't understand. Why did they speak about in Mitzrayim? Ela vaday shamru kach, keshelo shamu el Moshe, mikotzer ruach u'me'avoda kasha. So when Egyptians were running after them, they said to Moshe, didn't we tell you this in Mitzrayim? So what did they say? They said to Moshe Rabbeinu, our time is not up. Don't take us out. ועכשיו אמרו הלא טוב היה לעבוד מלמוד וליפול לגיהנום. Now in the desert they complained to Moshe Rabbeinu. It would be better for us to die there than here suffering and go to Geinom. Moshe Amad Lahem, Hityatsu Uru, Moshe Rabbeinu said, wait and see. Kelomar, Hayishua Vagula, Hi Geulat Olam. Moshe Rabbeinu said, don't worry, guys. No matter what we have, we will never see slavery again. Suffering here, suffering there, that suffering, small suffering, will cut everything away. We'll cut 430 years away, but we will never be slaves again because this freedom, freedom of life. Forever. שאם לא היו חוטאים בעגל, היה להם חירות משיבוד מלכיות, כמו שאמרו חז"ל. As the rabbis say, if Jewish nation wouldn't serve idols, we would never see no Holocaust at all. So that idols brought back 220 years for us. Shashem should always protect us and keep us safe. וכן יהי רצון מאמר.